Well, here's something to think about. Going on a honeymoon with your new husband and your ex-husband.
An A-list actress did just that. While it may sound strange, our Greg Argos found out there are some positives to it.
The relationship is over, so what's next?
Out of sight, out of mind is better.
Many believe a clean break helps them move forward.
You're just like back to like square one.
I don't think I could ever stand to see someone that I was dating date somebody else.
So it's no surprise the reaction folks are having about Gwyneth Paltrow's honeymoon.
She went on her honeymoon with her new husband and brought along her ex.
Wow.
That's weird.
That's like me bringing my girlfriend and my ex to a date together.
It doesn't work.
It doesn't work like that.
What do you think would happen if you did that today? You'd have two ex-girlfriends.
In a recent interview, the actress says she went with her ex, her current husband, and their kids to the Maldives. She calls it the modern honeymoon.
She could call it what she wants. I think it's one man, one woman, period.
That does sound new.
Dr. George Jones is a senior therapist with the Council for Relationships and says Paltrow's decision is unique.
I'm not really surprised by much, but that does sound pretty surprising.
But Jones says couples have tried to stay in touch after a divorce, especially if they have children together. Many even stay friends. The key, Jones says, is to over-communicate.
There has to be a lot of clear communication and honesty. Because it's easy for someone in that kind of trio to be jealous or to be nervous about what's really going on.
For some, that's easier said than done.
Get out of each other's lives, block each other on social media.
Move on.
Move on.
Now, experts say keeping in touch with an ex-spouse is not a great idea for couples who may have resentment or anger issues with one another. Seems like common sense, of course. As for going on a honeymoon with an ex, jury's still out on whether that's going to catch on.